But only God will make them to come to pass.
When
I realized my life was useless without Jesus Christ, especially when I was in Form
3,
I was facing the grave. And my life became difficult. I almost gave up in life until I found Jesus, who brought meaning into my life. He gave me hope, and that hope has kept me going over 20 years from that time. A time that I thought I was going to die, a time that I totally gave up, but God gave me hope. And from that time, it's now 20 years down the line, and I can look back and say God is faithful. Brothers and sisters, I'm requesting that you give us a short time to share the word of God with you. Those who are walking away, it's possible this is your word. It's possible something that God wants to do in your life. Walking away. You never know why God has brought us here. God has brought us here with a reason and a purpose. Because there is somebody that God wants to deliver from the devil's life. There is somebody God wants to snatch from the devil. And that is why we have come to this place tonight. Our God is so good, and He loves everybody. We have been here since Tuesday, not sharing our ideas, not telling you anything, but sharing the story of Jesus Christ. Sharing the redemption story of Jesus Christ. And even tonight, which is our second last day, we want to share with you about the life of Jesus Christ. Every time God gives me an opportunity to stand before His people, I share the word of God with all of my heart. Because I am aware that I may be talking to somebody here who is listening to me for the last time. I am also aware that I am talking to somebody who may never have an opportunity of hearing the word of God another time. Because many times I have preached to meetings, and after I am left, you gave bad stories. So was in that meeting, and so has died. So every time God gives me an opportunity, I don't waste my time. I don't pray that opportunity. I share the word of God with the whole of my heart. Because I also understand that I may never know that this is the last day I am sharing the word of God with the people of God. I share the word of God. As though it is my last day on earth, so that somebody who had an opportunity to hear from me won't have an excuse that one day, one morning, when we shall appear before the Father, we shall be giving testimonies before the eternal throne that you shall say, yes, I have the word of God. I have the word of God. Oh, I despise the word of God. But the fact remains, I have the word of God. Power of God, that's why we are here tonight. Jesus Christ,
the Lord of the earth,
and you despise and ignore. The Bible says, and I, brethren, when I came to you, did not come with excellence of speech, power of wisdom, but declaring to you the testimony of God. So I determined not to know anything among you except Jesus Christ, and Him crucified. I determined not to know anything except Jesus Christ, and Him crucified. This is Paul the Apostle writing. And he's writing to the church in Corinth. Paul had gone to Corinth and preached there. Just like we have come to my rally to preach, and after preaching in Corinth, Paul planted a church there. And after some days, after some months have passed, Paul decided lady write to them a letter. And the letter he was writing, he was addressing the issues that were going on in the church of Corinth. Periodically, he used to receive a report on what is going on in the church of Corinth. And now Paul decides to address all those issues by writing a letter to the church of Corinth. And he says, where I have read, when I came to you, I never came with an excellent speech. I never came to tell you what you wanted to hear. When I came to you, I never came to boast to you. But I came to share the word of God, the mercies of God, the redemptive story of Jesus Christ. And then in verse 2 says, that I determined not to know anything except the love of Jesus Christ and Him crucified. Then I go to the church of Corinth and saw children who are in school. And the children who are in school, and they are saying that one day I will become a doctor. That one day I want to work hard. I become a teacher like so and so. That one day I will grow up. I want to become a pilot. And Paul observed them and he realized that not everything they were saying was coming true. He was saying, they were saying that one day when I grow up, and Paul observed that some of those people died before they achieved those dreams. Paul looked at old mamas. They are saying, maybe let me take my children to school. But Paul observed that that one was not coming to pass. People could take their children to school, and the children could drop out of school. Some take their children to school, and the children continue in schooling.
Jesus,
he gives you hope.
Even
before beyond the grave. as you are taking your children to school. And when God comes in the cool of the day,
and the Lord is sitting at the
table, He wants to come every day.
And the Lord is the
ownership in the man that He had created.
And the Lord is the man
that He comes and finds Adam is not there. At the exact point where they used to meet.
And
He calls Adam, where are you? And that marked the beginning of the redemption story. After the fall of man, God started the campaign of bringing man back to himself. He says, Adam, where are you? Adam says, I heard your voice. I discovered I was naked. It is sin that drove man out of the presence of God.
Child
of God loves you so much. That is why in that very evening, He launched a campaign.
The
campaign started in the Garden of Eden, bringing back man to himself, so that He could buy man back to himself.
Yes,
I got Jesus came.
Yes,
and died at the death of shame.
I have poor so.
He died so that me and you could come up to Jesus. At the cross of Calvary, Jesus was killed.
Yes,
Jesus was hanged and shaved.
Yes,
and before Jesus died,
yes,
all true God was with Jesus. And at that time, the darkness fell upon the face of the earth. Darkness all over the face of the earth. And the Bible says, at that point Jesus cried. And he said, Eloi, Eloi, lama sabachthani. At that point, Jesus died.
Yes,
power of God. There was darkness in the face of the
earth.
God looked at his beloved son.
Yes,
Jesus was carrying all the sins of the world.
Yes,
carrying your sins and my sins. All my sins were carried upon by him.
Not
just the way it's really hard, but I'm not going to be is about Jesus Christ.
I gave my life to Jesus as a gift.
guarda em isso.
I remember people
laughed. I can
only
laugh.
I
can't
laugh.
I can't
laugh.
I can't
laugh.
I
can't
laugh.
I can't
laugh.
I can't
laugh.
I can't laugh.
I
can't
laugh.
I can't laugh.
I can't
laugh.
I can't laugh.
I
can't
laugh.
I can't
laugh.
I
can't laugh.
I can't Jesus Christ.
friend of mine was laughing at me. That's how my friend died. Children of God, there is no hope in Jesus Christ. You can have a good job, but you still need Jesus in your life. You can have a good education, but you need Jesus Christ. You may be driving a good car, and you need Jesus Christ. You may be driving a good car, but you need Jesus Christ. When I came to you, who can change your life.
And I want you
to pray with somebody.
Want to pray with somebody tonight.
Of God, by the mercies of God, I request that you move closer here with me
together.
Everybody pray that you move closer here. By the mercies of God that you move closer here. I love this mama, she has been listening to us. We have been listening about the word of God. And God has spoken to you. And we want to pray together with you.
We are presenting to you nothing but the love of Jesus Christ.
The story of Jesus Christ. Those dear brothers in the We request all of you to come to church so that we celebrate the dream of Jesus Christ. Want to pray to God. We have shared the word of God. I request that you close your eyes, Father God. We have shared the word of God.
Naomba unisamehe. Andika jina langu katika kitabu cha uzima. Nimekubali kwamba mimi ni mwenye dhambi. Natubu dhambi zangu. Naomba unisamehe. Baba, nakupatia maisha yangu. Uniongoze. Unidumishe katika upendo wako. Nifundishe neno lako. Nifundishe kudumu katika maombi. Nifundishe e Bwana kukutii siku zote za maisha yangu. Pokea ombi langu katika jina la Yesu Kristo. Amen. Let's believe together as we pray. Father Almighty, Lord.
We
come before you tonight. We have shared your word. We have planted a seed in my life. We have planted a seed in this
field.
Oh my Father, I pray that the seed will
germinate.
The seed will bear fruit. From Marani. The corners of the earth.
The church
out of this place.
We
are raising our people.
They
are going to take your gospel to the
earth.
Out of this place.
We
are raising the church.
We
shall profess Jesus Christ.
And they
are coming out of this place.
We
are raising police officers. I pray that today
Christ.
Every stronghold in this place.
It's
in a position to your
heart.
I have
it in
the name of Jesus.
Jesus,
I declare peace in this village.
I declare
the peace of Jesus in
this
village. In the name of Jesus,
I
worship you, Lord.
In the
house of David,
in
Jesus' name.
Amen.
Let's give a clap of
praise
to God. Amen. Biamono. Hallelujah. Wakati wamebarikiwa na ujumbe wa Bwana, tumshukuru Bwana kwa umbali ambao ametuleta. Kesho ndio itakuwa siku yetu ya mwisho, na nataka niseme au nitangaze ya kwamba mkutano huu umeletwa na kanisa la MCC lililoko hapa chini Nyansaga. Tunawapenda watu wa Sensi. Na kesho tutakuwa na wageni pale kanisani. Njoo uombewe, njoo umwabudu Mungu. Tumekualika ukaweze kuja kushiriki pamoja nasi siku ya kesho tunapomuinua Yesu na tunaposhangilia kwa matendo yake makuu. Kwa hivyo tunasema ni asante watu wa Sensi kwa kuweza kumpenda Mungu na kukubali kuweza kuja na kusikiza yale ambayo Mungu anataka uyasikie, na hata kupokea wokovu wako na kupokea uponyaji wako. Mungu akubariki unapoendelea kuyatoa maisha yako kuwa dhabihu kwa ajili ya Mungu. Umwakilishe Mungu mahali hapa. Tumekuja hapa sio kwa sababu yetu, sio kwa sababu tunakutoa kwa kanisa letu. Kama uko na kanisa, kesho enda katika hilo kanisa umwabudu Bwana. Haleluya. Na kama wewe hauna kanisa, tumekualika. Kanisa letu ni kanisa nzuri, tunamtumikia Bwana. Umetuona tuko hapa tunamhubiri Yesu. Tunakualika ukaweza kushiriki nasi katika ibada ya kesho. Inaanza saa 3 kamili mpaka saa 6. Saa 8 tunakuja hapa kumalizia crusade, na tumekualika. Amen. Kutakuwa na siku kuu ya baraka siku ya kesho. Karibu kanisani, tumekualika kwa moyo wa furaha. Nakaribisha waimbaji hawa wakaweze kutukamilishia kabla hatujamaliza maombi ya mwisho. Mungu awabariki sana. Amen. Amen.